majesty, we will bow before his throne. We will worship him in righteousness. We will worship him alone. He is Lord of heaven, Lord of earth. He is Lord of all who lives. He is Lord above the universe. All praise to him we give. Alleluia to the King of Kings. Alleluia to the Lamb. Alleluia to the Lord of Lords, who is the great I Am.
Our next song this evening will be Hero Israel 141.
Hear, O Israel, the Lord God is one God. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all of thy strength. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all of thy soul. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy strength. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy mind. Hear, O Israel, thou shalt love the neighbor. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all of thy heart. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all of thy soul. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all of thy strength. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all of thy heart. Hear, O Israel.
Our next song this evening will be Days of Elijah.
And these are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of your These are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness be restored. And these are days of great trials, of famine and darkness and sword. Still we are the voice in the desert, crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on a cloud, shining like the sun at the trumpet call. So lift your voice, this year of Jubilee, his eye until salvation comes. And these are the days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding the temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest, the fields are as wide in your world. Send we are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on a cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, so lift your voice. It's the year of Jubilee, and out of Zion till salvation comes. Behold, he comes, riding on a cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, so lift your voice. But you believe, and that is I until salvation comes.
Will you bow with me? Dear Lord, thank you for this day, and thank you for letting us all gather here and worship you, and let us learn more about you and grow stronger in your word, and watch over us as we go through this night and head back to our homes. In Jesus' name, amen.
James 2:10. For whoever keeps the whole law and yet stumbles as just one point is guilty of breaking it. And Isaiah 59:2. But your iniquities have separated you from your God. Your sins have hidden his face from you, so that you will not hear.
The first song that I will be singing is We Shall Assemble.
We shall assemble on the mountain. We shall assemble at the throne with humble hearts into his presence. We bring an offering of song, glory and honor and dominion unto the Lamb, unto the King. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. We sing the song of the redeemed. We shall assemble on the mountain. We shall assemble at the throne with humble hearts into his presence. We bring an offering of song, glory and honor and dominion unto the Lamb, unto the King. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. We sing the song of the
next song that I will be singing is His Grace Reaches Me.
Deeper than the ocean and wider than the sea is the grace of the Savior for sinners like me. Yeah. His yes, His grace reaches me. Yes, His grace reaches me. And to last through eternity. Now I'm under His control, and I'm happy in my soul just to know that His grace reaches me. Higher than the mountains and brighter than the sun, it was offered at Calvary for everyone. Great is the treasures, and it's mine today. Sins were as scarlet, He has washed them away. His grace, His grace reaches me. Yes, His grace reaches me. And to now I'm under His control, and I'm happy in my soul just to know that His grace reaches me.
The last song for me is Lamb of God.
Your only Son, no sin to hide, but You have sent Him from Your side to war among His guilty heart and to become the Lamb of God. O Lamb of God, sweet Lamb of God, I love the holy Lamb of God. O wash me in His precious blood, my Jesus Christ the of God. Your gift of love they crucified, they laughed and scorned Him as He died. The humble King they named a God, and sacrificed by Your staff and rod.
I will be reading from Isaiah 64:6. We have all became like one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like a polluted garment. We all fade like a leaf, and our iniquities like the wind take us away. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in him should not perish but have everlasting life. That's from John 3:16.
Our next song will be I Will Call Upon the Lord. Let's sing.
I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemy. The Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. The Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. Jesus Christ, he died for me, and he took away my sins. I will live with him for eternity. The Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. The Lord liveth, and blessed be the rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. I will call upon the Lord.
Our next song will be He Paid a Debt. He paid a debt he did not owe. I owed a debt I did not owe. I needed someone to wash my sins away. And now I sing a brand new song, Amazing Grace. Christ Jesus paid the debt that I could never pay. He paid that debt at Calvary. He cleansed my soul and set me free. I need that Jesus did all my sins erase. I now can sing a brand new song, Amazing Grace. Christ Jesus paid the debt that I could never pay. One day he's coming back for me to live with him eternally. Won't it be glory to see him on that day? I then will sing a brand new song, Amazing Grace. Christ Jesus paid a debt that I could never pay. Our next song will be Light the Fire. Let's sing.
I stand to praise you, but I fall to my knees. My spirit is willing, but my flesh is so weak.
Light the fire in my soul, fan the flame, make me whole. Lord, you know where I've been, so light the fire in my heart again. I feel your arms around me as the power of your healing begins. Your spirit moves right through me like a mighty rushing wind. Light the fire in my soul, fan the flame, make me whole. Lord, you know where I've been, so light the fire in my heart again. Light the fire in my soul, fan the flame, light the fire in my heart again.
Scripture I'll be reading tonight is 1 John 4:9-10. In this the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. And this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for us, for our sins.
I know I'm not one of the youth, but I feel young despite the gray hair. You are my all in all. It'll be sung a little different than what we're used to. This is how I learned it, so it's how I want to sing it. Just real quick, everybody will sing the first verse together. Then the ladies will repeat that first verse, and the guys will sing the chorus. And everybody sings verse 2 together, and then the ladies sing the chorus as guys repeat verse 2, and then we all do the last slide. And just remember, when the two parts come together, the chorus starts, the verse is like a half step behind. Just follow along with the slides, you'll get it.
You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I seek. You are my all in all. Seeking you as a precious jewel, Lord, to give up I'd be a fool. You are my all in all. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Taking my sin, my cross, my shame, rising again, I bless your name. You are my all in all. When I fall down, you pick me up. When I am dry, you fill my cup. You are my all in all.
Ladies.
Taking my sin, my cross, my shame, rising again, I bless your name. You are my all in all. When I fall down, you pick me up. When I am dry, you fill my cup. You are my all in all. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name.
I know the ending's a little different. Sorry, that's how I learned it. You're the One is our next song tonight.
Lord, the people praise you. Lift you up and raise you. For you are the Holy One. You're the One, you're the only One. Lord, the people love you. Place nobody above you, for you are the Holy One. You're the One, you're the only One. Singing holly, holly, hallelujah. All the glory is due you, for you are the Holy One. You're the One, you're the only One. Bless your name, Lord Jesus. Only name that frees us. For you are the Holy One. You're the One, you're the only One. We will bless you here and now. Bless the hills and rocks, cry out. For you are the Holy One. You're the One, you're the only One. Sing a holly, holly, hallelujah. All the glory is to you. For you are the Holy One. You're the One, you're the only One. You're the One, you're the only One.
I will be reading from Romans chapter 3, verses 24 through 26. And are justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a propitiation by his blood to be received by faith. This was to show God's righteousness, because in his divine forbearance he had passed over former sins. It was to show his righteousness at the present time, so that he might be just and the justifier of the one who has faith in Jesus. We'll have two more songs before one of our young men is going to come up and speak to you. He is nervous, so don't stare at him. Sing and be happy. You know what? We got to stand for this one. And we got to have smiles, because it's a happy song.
If the skies above you are gray, you are feeling so blue. If your cares and burdens seem great all the whole day through, there's a silver line that shines in the heavenly land. Look by faith and see it, my friend. Trust in his promises grand. Sing and be happy. Press on to the goal. Trust him who leads you. He will keep your soul. Let all be faithful. Look to him and pray Lift your voice and praise Him in song. Sing and be happy today. Often we are troubled and tired, sick with sorrow and pain. There are others living in sin, blessed with earthly gain. Take new courage, we cannot tell what the morrow may bring. When the dark clouds vanish away, then your heart truly can sing. Sing and be happy, press on to the goal. Trust Him who leads you, He will keep your soul. Let all be faithful, look to Him and pray. Lift your voice and praise Him in song. Sing and be happy today. Oft we fail to see the rainbow up in heaven's fair sky. When it seems the fortunes of earth frown and pass us by. There are things we know that are worth more than silver and gold. If we hope and trust Him each day, we shall have pleasure untold. Sing and be happy, press on to the goal. Trust Him who leads you, He will keep your soul. Let all be faithful, look to Him and pray. Lift your voice and praise Him in song. Sing and be happy today.
You may be seated. One more song before Chris will come up here and give us a short devotional. We will sing Firm Foundation.
Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I know I can stand secure. Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I put my hope in your holy word. I put my hope in your holy word. I have a living hope. I have a future. God has a plan for me. Of this I'm sure. Of this I'm sure. Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I know I can stand secure. Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I put my hope in your holy word. I put my hope in your holy word. Your word is faithful, mighty in power. God will deliver me. Of this I'm sure. Of this I'm sure. Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I know I can stand secure. Jesus, you're my firm foundation. I put my hope in your holy word. I put my hope in your holy word.
Tonight we're going to be talking about the grace of God. If you would, turn in your Bibles with me to Acts chapter 20, verse 24. This says, But I do not account my life of any value, nor as precious to myself, if only I may finish my course in the ministry that I received from the Lord Jesus to testify to the gospel of the grace of God. In this chapter, Paul is talking of the ministry he received from Jesus. If you would look at the second part of that verse again, it says, to testify to the gospel of the grace of God. And this verse, gospel is the good news, and grace is the unmerited favor of God. So if you look at that again, filling in the blanks, it's to testify to the good news of the unmerited favor of God. Paul was given the ministry to proclaim the good news. Well, now you might ask yourself, what is the good news? Well, it's two things. A, God provided a way to salvation for sinners. And B, he did this without requiring merit on our part or on the part of sinners. The need for grace. Well, we all need grace. There is no one worthy of the kingdom of heaven without the gift of God's grace. If you would turn with me to Romans chapter 3, verse 23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God and are justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. This clearly states that all of us are sinners and we all need the gift of God's grace to get to heaven. If you would look with me at Romans chapter 6, verse 23. For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. We all sin. None of us deserve eternal life with our Father, but God grants us a free gift, which is the eternal life with him. Well, how do you earn grace? Well, there's three steps. First, you have to plead guilty of your sin. You have to accept the fact that we're all sinners and we all need God's grace. Everyone sins and falls short. We're not good enough for heaven without the gift of God's grace. And even the best of us are without merit in God's eyes. Second, our sins alienate or separate us from God. By our transgressions, we lose our relationship with God. Our sins alienate or separate us from God. When this happens, we experience spiritual death from God. If spiritual death is not fixed, then we experience eternal separation from God. In spiritual death or eternal separation, we are dead to God. Our prayers are not heard. You see this in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 12. For the eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are open to their prayers. But the face of the Lord is against those who do evil. All right. Third, we cannot accomplish removal of guilt of our own sin. You can't run from sin. You can't work off sin. You can't hide from sin or your guilt. Don't be deceived by your own goodness. We are all sinners and all need salvation with God. The first requirement for salvation is recognition of your sins. Once you realize your sinful nature, you can work towards salvation. If you have any guilt weighing you down tonight, you can't handle it on your own, or if you need the prayers for any reason, if you're spiritually dead and want to come back to the church, it's not too late. If you want to begin your journey tonight with Christ by putting him on in baptism, then please come forward now as we stand and sing.
My light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of stilled when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all. Here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save, still on that cross as Jesus died, the wrath of God was at his. Death of Christ I live. There in the ground his body lay, heart of the world by darkness slain, then bursting forth in glorious grave he rose again, and as he stands in victory, sin's curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand till he returns or calls. Power of Christ, I'll stand.
Stay up here. That's all right. If you didn't feel that last song, I need to visit with you. Maybe the elders need to visit with you. Whenever it talked about sin's curse lifted from us, didn't you just feel it being lifted again? And to know that it has no control over us anymore. What a marvelous feeling. This afternoon, we saw some marvelous things over at North Star. Our ladies are doing an excellent job over there. They made a commitment about 2.5 years ago to go every Sunday afternoon. And if you've never been, you need to go visit. Not saying that you have to go every week, but you need to go see. There's anywhere from 10 to 30, 35 children, all the way up through teenagers, that come. And they're learning. In fact, they wanted some others that work over there, not a church group right now, but some others that worked there wanted to put together a chorus or a choir and do a presentation for the parents today of songs. And so they brought in someone to help teach them and help teach them the music and everything, and the kids already knew the songs. And they said, how in the world did they learn these songs? And they said, the Church of Christ comes over every Sunday afternoon. And they sang two of those songs today. And their harmony wasn't perfect. It was like ours sometimes. But it just thrilled my heart to see these children and the impression that's being made. And to know the decisions that are going to come in their life later because of what's happening right now. Now that's every Sunday afternoon. Now, yeah, how many of us have an opportunity during the week to teach a class to 35 children all the way up through teenagers who are not the children of our members? That's evangelism. And Dave Olson, he and the ones that work in prison, Mariana, every week they teach between 100 and 120 people. Every week. And these people come to the classes voluntarily. They don't have to. And they keep participating. They keep learning. How many preachers would love to be in an environment where they could teach the Bible to 115, 120 people outside of Christ every week? Amazing. Amazing the opportunities that are here. I'm going to tell you one more. See, they didn't let me do the devotional tonight. I've got to tell you one more. Friends speak. And you may read about this. John may write something about this, but I'm not going to mention the name, and I'm not going to mention me being the teacher because I don't want the student to pick it up. I had one of the first students, husband and wife, and Dina comes and helps, and I haven't even told Dina because last Wednesday, when the husband came, the wife didn't come, and so she said, well, I've got other things I can do, so, you know, not a problem. And so it was just me and Faneo. And we had started back in November. Was it in November, October, December? September. Whoa, we've been doing this for a long time. And faithfully, you know, and they've come to our house for some get-togethers, and they've taken us out to eat, and we've become friends. And so he read, and we're reading from the Gospel of Luke. And after we finished the lesson, we pray together. And after we prayed, he said, could I ask you something? And I said, sure. He said, could I ask you something very personal? And then my fear started. I thought, oh no, he's going to ask for money. He's going to say, I've got somebody, you know, that, you know. And I said, sure, you can, for now, you can ask anything you want to ask. And he said, I really don't know how to say this. I thought, boy, you know, I was just so convinced what was coming. And he said, could you help me learn to know Jesus the way you know Jesus? Could you take the time to help me understand so I can teach other people? Wow. I said, what we've done is we've come to a time when we're going to close this workbook, and starting this next Wednesday afternoon, we're going to start going deeper and deeper. And I make a commitment to you that I'll stay with you until we get it done. He's a leader among the people, the immigrants here from Tonga, one of the South Pacific Islands. He said, I want to be able to teach my people. Wow. If you're not involved in FriendSpeak, there's room for you. Thank you.
During this next song, those who cannot partake of the communion, the Lord's Supper this morning, can go ahead down the hall, follow the crowds.
O Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you. Lord, teach your children to stop the fighting, start uniting all as one. Let's get together, loving forever, sanctuary for you. The one Lord who sent the Savior, heart and soul, Lord, for our land. It is you, Lord, who knows our weakness. You refine us with your hand. Oh Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you.
Next song you'll be singing is As the Deer.
As the deer pants for the water, so my soul longs after you. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship you. You alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship you. You're my friend, and you are my brother, even though you are a king. I love you more than so much more than anything. You alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. You and I long to worship you. I want you more than good.
Nearly as young as a youth, but I'm not anywhere close as being old as Matt, but I'm up here now. All right, so before the prayer, just to throw it out there one more time like we did this morning, May 3rd, 6:30, we're going to have a barbecue game night here at the church building for the young adults and the youth, and the parents of the youth are welcome and strongly encouraged to come. And if you are going to come by, let myself or, well, I don't see her in here, but Courtney Brown know what dish or what food you want to bring so we don't have like 50 bags of potato chips and like one hamburger. So let's go to our Father in prayer. Dear Father, we come for you now as we're wrapping up our worship service here tonight. Lord, we want to thank you for blessing us with the youth that were able to get up here and lead the services, Lord. I want to thank you for the families of the youth as well that encourage them to follow you, to encourage them to get up here to lead praises to you, Lord, and to read your word, Lord. We want to ask that you be with us as we go throughout our daily lives, Lord, and keep us in the palm of your hand, Lord, and guide, guard, and direct our footsteps, Lord. We also want to pray that you'll open our eyes and ears to the opportunities around us. And when those opportunities arise, Lord, we want to ask you to place the words on our lips that we need to speak so we can help further your word and plant the seeds for those around us. And be with all those who are on the prayer list and just keep them in the palm of your hand and let your will be done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.